Hello, welcome to my faux fur sliders tutorial. I purchased the sliders from Five Below. Then you can get E6000 from pretty much any store that sells adhesives, a soft ruler, scissors, some sewing pins, and the faux fur. All right, let's get started. First, you want to go ahead and remove the tag. Next, you want to take your measuring tape and measure. You want to measure across for the width. So I go from one side to the next. This one stops at about 6.5. And then you want to do the other side, which measures out to almost 7¾. So I'm going to cut it at 7¾, and then you want to measure the depth, which is this side is a little just shy of 3 inches. Then you go around, it gets to about 2¾, and then it goes back around to close to 3 inches, but to be on the safe side, we'll do 3. So again, you want to do both sides. 3 and 8. That's what the measurements we're going to use. So with the faux fur, I turn it upside down and to cut it. It just makes it a little bit easier. And I'll have my pins. And I need to cut 2 of them for both sliders. So I'll go out to 8 right here. And then I'll put a pin. Just to mark it on both sides. And then I'm gonna go 3. And I'd rather have too much than not enough. I'll be able to cut it while it is adhered to the slider. I'll start with, I'll just cut slightly over. And then I'm going to do the same. This one had a slightly wrinkle, so I'm gonna go on this side. Go over to 8. And then mark at 3. Keeping in mind, I'm going to cut any extra faux fur off when it's on the slider. Now I have my 2 pieces. So let's go ahead and see how they fit on the slider. Oh, that's beautiful. I like how that fits. I'm gonna first and then just stretch it all around. Nice. There we go. That looks good to me. So I'm gonna go ahead and get my E6000 out. I'm gonna glue around the perimeter and then inside in the middle so it can stay down. Just wanna make sure I really get it. try to start in the center. It does move a little bit if you need to, if it's a little off initially, just to make some adjustments before it actually becomes permanent and no longer able to move. Okay. Now this is the extra that I was talking about. You can just turn upside down. I kind of brushed the faux fur and then cut. And the same on this side. And now all I really need to do is to check to see if any lifting, any spots I missed. I want to add some more. A little bit right here. Just really want to get those corners down really well. First one's done. Let's go to the second one. Let's fit it. Fits nicely, goes over just slightly, which is anticipated. Add the E6000 around the perimeter and then in the middle. Then I typically just kind of start in the middle and stretch it around. Then again, you can move it. It's before it becomes permanent, if you need to make any type of adjustments. There we go. That all covers up. Good. Flip it up, turn it around, rest the faux fur in the opposite direction. All right, same thing on the other side. All right. Check to see if there's any lifting. Then lay it. It's really these corners you want to make sure you get. That one's pretty good, but I'll just do one for good measure. Awesome. Then I'll The type of faux fur I got, it kind of sheds initially only when you cut it. Once it's on there, it doesn't shed. And now I have my faux fur sliders.